Hello everyone, there is a good news for all of us. Finally, NABARD grade A and grade B exam notification has come out. In this video, we are going to talk about what are the important dates, how many vacancies are there, and what is the exam pattern. If you have any confusion regarding form filling and everything, watch this video, your doubt will be cleared. First, we'll talk about important dates of grade A examination. You can fill the form between 10th May to 26th May, and your phase 1 exam will happen on 15th June. So mark this date, this is very important. Mains date would be announced after phase 1 examination separately on the website. For grade B examination, form filling date is same as grade A. You can fill the form between 10th May to 26th May, but phase 1 exam will happen for grade B on 16th June. But for grade A, exam will happen on 15th and 16th both day, and mains date would be announced separately on the website after phase 1 examination. You must be wondering how many vacancies are in grade A examination. There are total 79 vacancies. Out of these 79, 41 vacancies are for generalist, other are for specialist. In specialist, economics and agriculture economics vacancy is there, environment vacancy is there, food processing vacancies there, forestry, finance, land development, plantation vacancies there. For generalists, there are total 41 vacancies. Out of these 41, 17 are for general category. So this is the vacancy status in grade A examination. In grade B examination, there are total 8 vacancies. Out of these 8 vacancies, 4 are for general category, other are for reserve category. And these vacancies are for generalist only. There is no specialist vacancy in grade B. This is the vacancy status for grade B examination. Now we'll discuss about exam pattern. Examination will consist of two phases, phase 1, phase 2, followed by interview. And this is same for grade A and grade B examination. Phase 1 examination is for 2 hours and it contains 200 marks. Out of these 200, English will be for 40 marks, reasoning will be for 20 marks, quant will be for 20 marks, computer knowledge would be for 20 marks, general awareness would be for 20 marks, economic and social issues would be for 40 marks, agriculture and rural development would be for 40 marks. In general awareness paper, 15 to 20 marks would be from current affairs, rest are static portion. In economic issues, 20 to 30 marks would be from current affairs, 10 to 15 marks would be from static portion. In agriculture and rural development, out of 40 marks, 10 to 15 marks would be current affairs, 20 to 30 marks would be from static portion. This is phase 1 examination and this is same for grade A and grade B examination. Let's talk about phase 2 examination. For grade A exam, phase 2 consists of 2 papers, 100 marks each, and you would be given 1.5 hours for each paper. First paper is descriptive English. It contains 100 marks and you have to write subjective answer for this paper. Second paper is economic and social issues and agriculture and rural development. It contains 100 marks. Out of these 100 marks, 50 marks would be economic and social issues and 50 marks would be agriculture and rural development. This is for grade A examination only. In grade B examination, you have one extra paper, development economics, statistics, finance and management. Here total 3 paper, each 100 marks, and you would be given 1.5 hours for each paper. This is for grade B examination, you remember that. What is the selection process? Candidates will be required to write all the papers online. Only successful candidate of phase 1 will appear for phase 2 examination on later date. Based on the result of phase 2 examination, candidates will be shortlisted for interview. Final selection will be through merit list, which will be prepared by adding marks secured by candidates in phase 2 and interview. Interview will contain 25 marks. After adding phase 2 marks in interview, final result will be displayed. So this is the selection process. You should remember that. Hope you have liked the video. If you have liked the video, do let us in the comment section. If you are facing any problem in filling the form, do write in the comment section. We'll try to resolve your problem. Thank you and happy learning.